From ships purposely sunk to create coral reefs to shipwrecks of Spanish galleons, here are abandoned ships in the Caribbean. Hey guys, this is American Eye today. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy that video. Number 12, Montego Bay Pirate Treasure. Montego Bay, located on the island of Jamaica, is an infamous place where pirates commonly lurked. So make for an excellent location to search for pirate treasure. A group of American treasure hunters set sail in the Jamaican waters, hoping to snatch some booty. The 17th century English vessel named the Manticore was badly damaged and found in international waters just outside the Jamaican border limit. One of the scuba divers, Rick Miller, describes it as being an amazing experience with gold and silver everywhere. Treasures one can only dream of. Just the weight of the precious metals alone is worth $187 million. Number 11, USS Oriskany. One of the first aircraft carriers of its kind, this ship was named after a famous battle during the Revolutionary War and is designed with a long hull. It was finally commissioned in the 1950s and served two conflicts, one in the Korean and one in Vietnam. In 1966, it broke out into flames after a magnesium flare was ignited, then it finally was decommissioned in 1976. It was sold for scraps in 1995, but repossessed in 1997 when the owner wasn't doing much with it. Finally, in 2004, researchers came up with a plan to actually sink this carrier with C4 explosives and transformed it into an artificial reef off the coast of the Gulf of Mexico near Florida. It was carefully demolished in order to keep it intact so it wouldn't let off toxic chemicals into the water. The ship is currently under about 145 feet of water and has shifted 10 feet deeper after a hurricane hit the area. It's currently the largest ship that's been turned into an artificial reef and occasionally visited by scuba divers. Now it's been dubbed as the Great Carrier Reef as a colloquial term. Number 10, Captain Morgan's Ship. Another great find for our archaeology. Of course, people know of Captain Morgan as the guy in the delicious bottles of rum, but did he actually exist? Despite making ugly girls look pretty, he was also the owner of many boats and an extremely successful privateer who looted many Spanish settlements in the Caribbean. He died in 1688 from cirrhosis of the liver, most likely from intaking too much of his own supply. One of his lost five ships was uncovered by an excavation team in 2010 and came up with six cannons. But most of the remains of the boat weren't actually eroded. The artifacts uncovered will help bring some life to the mythical character. Although they didn't find massive amounts of gold this time, the explorer crew considers the boat itself to be a priceless treasure. The six cannons are currently on display in a museum in Panama. Number 9, Richmond P. Hobson Shipwreck. Not a whole lot of information on this one out there on the web, but many photos have emerged. This completely rusted abandoned ship was built by the US. One day in July of 1963, the ship encountered some shallow water and hit ground near the Bahamas. Named after a US admiral that served from 1907 to 1915, it's now stuck on the Hogstie Reef. Strangely enough, it met its end exactly 20 years to the day once it was launched from North Carolina. It was built by the North Carolina Shipbuilding Company and worked as a cargo ship. Throughout her career, she bore flags of the UK, Yugoslavia, the US, and Panama. But sometimes when it's dark, it's not always easy to see when those reefs are coming up, which do cause a lot of wrecks. The iron of the ship is consumed by bacteria who feast on the stuff, which would almost make you assume they could live in iron-rich environments such as Mars. Coral and other organisms seemingly take shelter there too, almost making the wrecked ship like its own environment or something. Number 8, HMS Vixen. Everyone knows about the Bermuda Triangle and how ships go missing there all the time. What could be the reason for this? It's still a big mystery. The HMS Vixen was just guilty of getting hit by a hurricane, and attempts to fully repair the British naval gunboat were a little bit difficult. A local scrap metal merchant was interested in purchasing it, but its fate would be at the bottom of the sea. It turns out that the ship was intentionally detonated in 1895 in order to serve as some kind of defensive barrier. All of her engines were removed, but this will be her final resting place. It's currently sitting on the west end of Bermuda and has been restored to have scuba divers check it out. Number 7, Allistown, Bimini, Bahamas. Allistown is a tourist trade center located in the Caribbean country of the Bahamas. With several bars and things to do here, there's no reason to ever leave. It doesn't seem like this wrecked ship will be leaving anytime soon either. It's definitely becoming quite the attraction. Bimini is also home to the mysterious Bimini Road, which many feel as though it was left by an ancient civilization that's now underwater. But this artifact here is found on Radio Beach, where the sand is not so soft. The wreck here we see is of the Gallant Lady, who washed up after hurricane in 1997. This steel freighter ship has rusted quite a bit and won't be too long before it's completely disintegrated. Number 6. Sandy Ground, Anguilla. This village on the tiny island of Anguilla is home to a local secret. Walking along, the people are sure to discover this shipwreck, which is also becoming one of their biggest tourist attractions. The beaches are lined with bars and various yachts, which cruise the bayside. It's one of the busiest places in the Caribbean for boat traffic. So you can imagine there might be a couple shipwrecks here and there. This ship here, in particular, seems to have a very peculiar look to it, and it must have been recent since there's still paint on it. People just really need to start watching out for land here more often. This one also doesn't have a ton of back information on it, but it appears to either be a fishing vessel or a yacht. It would be interesting to see what kind of ecosystem forms in this abandoned ship. Number 5. Abandoned ship, Turks and Caicos. The coral reefs are evidence that things which are beautiful can also be deadly. Some estimate that the Turks and Caicos are home to over 1,000 shipwrecks, including this cargo ship known as the Mega One Triton. This is a recently wrecked ship that washed up ashore after Hurricane Sandy and has been rusting away ever since. Many consider it to be an eyesore and a possible hazard to beachgoers, while others would argue that it's kind of cool and wanted to stay. This one is also found not too far away from the governor's residence in Waterloo, so it's likely it'll be removed one day. The beach here doesn't get overly crowded, and it seems like a nice island getaway. The ship is mostly above water, so you have to imagine it would be a good place for crabs or birds to take shelter. Maybe even pirates? Who knows? Number 4. Spanish Galleon Shipwreck. Found near the Dominican Republic, this is the type of discovery archaeologists dream of. About 4,000 feet deep lies two shipwrecks, complete with cannons, musket balls, as well as large amounts of wine and gin to go along. Oh yeah, and don't forget about the quicksilver that helped Spain mine gold. The wreck was discovered during an oil and gas survey, looking for the next place to build an oil rig. Most of the wood has eroded, but the copper frame was still intact, as well as the kitchen. What exactly was the ship's origins? Some claim it might have came from pirates from Texas around the Texas Revolutionary War or Mexican-American War. The research will act as a time capsule from the past and give us a better understanding of the daily lives of whoever manned this boat. Number 3. The SS Antilla. The title for the largest shipwreck in the Caribbean is the MS Antilla, which is found in Aruba. Once used as a German freighter ship, the crew had decided to set it ablaze to prevent the Allies from seizing the goods in 1939. The route home to Germany was blocked by the US, British, and French, and then the Dutch were sent to seize the vessel. All detainees, however, were sent on a banana boat to Jamaica. Today it serves as a huge scuba diver hotspot and even serves as a hawksbill turtle sanctuary. The ship went on to take more damage from a hurricane in 1953, causing it to break apart. Many feel as though the ship can no longer safely be explored. Would you take the chance of scuba diving in a possibly dangerous shipwreck? Number 2. Northern Light Shipwreck. Also known as the Elbow Wreck, this ship once traveled from the Great Lakes through the Mississippi River before making its final resting place in Key Largo, Florida. It was even one of the first American steam hull ships built here in the 1890s. The large ship was about to be transformed into a formidable traveler of the seven seas in the 1990s, but the owner changed his mind. During the economic hardship of the Great Depression, they decided to set the ship ablaze and collect the insurance money for it. However, the idea would turn out to be a failure, and the insurance company never paid the scammer. Today, experienced scuba divers plunge about 150 to 190 feet underwater to take a look at the broken ships. Many claim this is one of the best scuba diving spots in the Florida Keys for tourists to take advantage of, but of course, it might still be dangerous. And number 1. Spiegel Grove Wreck. The Key Largo community set to sink another ship. This time, it was the Spiegel Grove, a U.S. Navy landing dock ship. This was a 510-foot retired ship that could be used to create an artificial ecosystem for coral and fish. It was formerly a part of the Mothball Fleet, which were a bunch of abandoned naval ships that were being kept as a surplus. The ship was relocated, and during this process, it sank during a storm. Luckily, no one was injured, and it still sank in a good spot. Many scientists and biologists are excited to see the results of this potential habitat, and scuba divers are lining up to drop in. There's even an American flag still attached to the top like you see here in this photo. So what do you guys think of that video? Let us know in the comment section and be sure to subscribe for new videos every day.